In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Today, as we gather as a family to celebrate the Eucharist, and as we join also in a very different journey with all of our relatives, friends, neighbors, loved ones, family members who have died. You know, we've written the names of those who we have done the funeral for this year in our book. And yesterday, when I asked via flock note to send me names for those who have died, there are so many people in our community who are simply walking with a little pain and a lot of loss today. But we have hope, and hope does not disappoint us. Let's take a moment and simply walk, trusting in the light of Christ, that the Lord listens to us. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, and as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened, so may our hope of resurrection for your departed servants also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace, for if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality? Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person one might even find the courage to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. My friends in Christ, we are very much aware that when our individual lives come to an end and we breathe our last and step over from the worldly life, the material world, into the spirit world of God, that is our entry point into that life with Jesus, the Father, the Holy Spirit, for which we have longed. But the gospel today also reminds us of a second raising up. And Jesus mentions twice. This is the John 6 with the promise of the Eucharist. And so that the power of the Eucharist not only helps us at our individual death, but as Jesus said many times during the gospel, we may not have noticed it, because Jesus came to restore all things to their proper order, that is, the end of the world, the whole world will be remade in its original splendor before sin existed. And at that point, Jesus says there will be a new rising up from the dead. So we are already enjoying heaven, but there's a special second event. And what does that mean? It means that our mortal bodies, with all of our problems, our disfigurations, our illnesses, all of that, when Jesus restores all things at the end of the world, we too, our bodies will be restored to their splendor before sin. That is an amazing promise. And I think at times we fail to remember that. But Jesus says it twice today in the gospel, and is part of the fruitfulness of the resurrection of the Lord, that all things be restored in him. And so we ask ourselves, well, what will that look like? Well, it's like you have a photograph on your computer, and you go to Photoshop, and you want to make your picture, somebody else's picture, perfect, and you go in and you fix all the wrinkles and all the problems, and you come up with a picture of you that is priceless and perfect in every way. That is a tiny image of what will happen to us. What will happen is that our weak mortal bodies will take on this new aura that God will prepare for us. So my friends, today, as we reflect on the going forward of our relatives and friends, family members, all of those loved ones and others that for whom we pray, let us remember that we're praying for two things: their immediate entry into the spirit life of God, but also preparing for that day which will come. Remember in Matthew 25, when Jesus has a description of the judgment, final judgment, and what does he say? We will all be raised up, and there will be this final judgment. All of those who took care of others, fed the hungry, clothed the naked, comforted the sorrowing, helped prisoners, and all of that, they will be in the fullness of that new resurrection. And those who failed to do that will not. So my friends, as we're praying for our own immortality and we're praying for our own entry into the eternal life of God, we're praying for two events, both of which are beyond our comprehension and imagination. Only God, who is infinite, filled with limitless love and mercy, can make it happen. So let us rejoice. And let us not be so concerned that our bodies are getting old, that they're more mortal than we would like, because someday it's all going to change. As Jesus said, and everything the Father has given me, all of you will be raised up again in glory.
Please stand for our intercessions, and all of us bring to the altar the understanding that we know we are on this journey, but we listen to some beautiful readings today, but it also reminds us hope does not disappoint us. So let's take a moment and pray for all of our relatives who have died. Bring them to mind and ask the Lord may they rest in peace. Let us also pray for so many people who have died alone during these past 2 years because of COVID, different circumstances, and they simply had no one to hold their hand, and so many sacrifices from the health workers to do the impossible that they could see their families. Let's take a moment and pray for them. Let us also pray for all those who have died in tragic circumstances, accidents, so many of them, and so many people walking with pain because their loved ones have been tragically killed. May the God of healing carry them. Let us pray for our parishioners here at St. Charles and all those who called from the domestic church home, who are at home praying with the Eucharist, who also have sent us their names for their loved ones. Let's bring them to mind, and may God not disappoint us. Good and gracious God, we come to your table to present ourselves to be nourished by your Eucharist. But we also are on the journey, walking, fragile, knowing that you can only give us hope. May we continue to look through the journey towards being with you, the God of all life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servants may be taken up in glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in Him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Pope Francis, Jose, our bishop, all his assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Charles Borromeo, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As one family, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to each other a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Oh, an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your departed servants, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace, through Christ our Lord. You know, yesterday when I invited our parishioners to send me names, you know, so many of them have said, we were not able to have a funeral the way we would have liked to. So many of our people are going through so many things right now. Let's take a moment and simply focus on the light of Christ. May he walk with us to paradise. Hope does not disappoint us. And as we bless the Book of the Dead, and we bring the prayers of all those who are reaching out to simply find a way to trust in God. May the souls of the faithful departed rest in peace. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. We may go in peace. Have a blessed day.
You shall speak.